Good evening.
Hi.
Hi, Meenakshi. Today I have come to you with a question regarding spice magic. Spice magic is something which, is something that I really fancy upon. And as a practitioner and as a person who loves magic, I had been trying a lot, you know, with few ingredients that we keep seeing for, you know, sometimes for money, sometimes to, you know, create, you know, luck for a work that we are waiting, opening up blockages. So spice magic, can you tell us something about it? Like how these ingredients can create, you know, magic?
See, basically these ingredients, all ingredients, not only spice, but all ingredients that we have on this earth, which is natural, they all have a quality. It doesn't have to be spice only, but we are talking about spice today since it is very easily available for all in the kitchen.
Right.
And very basic things like what we have, whether we talk about sugar, we talk about brown sugar, we talk about coffee, we talk about clove, we talk about cinnamon, we talk about garlic, ginger, bay leaves, turmeric, chili pepper, pepper, white pepper, black pepper, vinegar. They all have some a lot of energy as far as attracting or repelling is concerned. So all these ingredients, they have their own qualities. But since it comes from a lot of hands, like right from the source, till it comes to us, when it reaches us, it loses its energy because it's been touched by too many people. It gets mixed up with all kinds of energies. So as practitioners, we cleanse it and bless it first. So that blessing and cleansing, it takes time. It depends on how clear your energy field is when you are working with it. Because see, for somebody like us who've been working for decades, now what happens is we are attuned to it. Like when we start working on something, it just takes one click to start working on it. But if you have to practice, or if you know, the number of years or the hours of practice that you put in into a particular practice, then what happens is you have to set it up. You have to either light a candle, do some incense, and clear up your space before you start blessing, and then start using the product. Like for me, I do it in a, as far as I mix up a lot of things, but when I buy something and when something gets into my house, before it gets into the house and I start using it, I bless it. Okay. Whether it is a packet of sugar, whether it is a packet of coffee or a container, or before I use it, I bless it always. And I cleanse that energy before I put that into food and do some, you know, do any cooking out of it.
So now I have a question, like there are a few ingredients, you know, which is talked about a lot. And one of that is vinegar and, if I can say, clove. Okay, and clove can be used for a lot of rituals. Similar, vinegar can be also used for a lot of good and bad rituals. Bad, I'm saying in the sense when you want to drive away things from you, right? So can you share one ritual with which is your favorite, you know, which you can share and which our viewers can, you know, do?
I wouldn't really call it a ritual, but something with bay leaves, which can be done. I think it's very commonly used and it's all over in the internet and all over YouTube or something. But what is burning up bay leaves. But better than that, I look at it as garlic and ginger. These two ingredients are my favorite as far as energy is concerned, as far as manifestation is concerned. You can put up a garlic clove under your pillow before you go to bed, and you can put a lot of bay leaves under your mattress. I mean, that way, if you keep it that way, you're removing negativity from your body when you're asleep, and you remove a lot of negativity from your mind, which is there. And garlic actually protects your thoughts and protects you from all kinds of negative intention of other people, because it'll protect your head. So basically, when any kind of negative ritual is done, when somebody else is trying to do something on you, what happens is they try to attack you when you're asleep.
Right.
So most of these practices are done at night, because the intention is basically when the person is asleep. So this garlic, what it does is when it is, you are sleeping, so that others can't affect you, you have to keep a garlic under it, and it will protect you or getting your mind influenced or manipulated by somebody else. So this is what I like. And I like ginger in the sense, I tell it to a lot of my clients that they can crush a little bit of ginger in the mortar and pestle. You know, you have to do it the traditional way. You have to use the mortar and pestle so that your energy goes in. And if you're talking about removing your negativity and protecting yourself. So you crush a little bit of ginger, and then you can put a little bit of black pepper in it, and you can put a little bit of basil as well, tulsi. Now you can boil this concoction, you can boil it, and you can put in coriander also if you want people committed to you in the house. Coriander is very good for commitments. So if you are talking about making this concoction and bringing it to a boil for about 10 minutes, and you can keep it with yourself, and then you can add it to your bath water whenever you're going for a shower or something, you can add to it. But best what I like is you can tie up these things, since most of us take a shower these days and we don't really take a bath. Mm-hmm. So you can actually tie it up in a cloth, in a muslin cloth, and you can hang it from your shower. So the water seeps in from there and you are getting a cleansed bath.
So I'll just ask one question regarding the clove that you, garlic, which you were saying, to put under the pillow. So once we keep it under the pillow, then what do we do with that garlic?
You can keep it there for a month. So okay. You don't have to change it for a month. It can be there for a month, or uh-huh. You can change it whenever you feel like. See, whenever we're talking about any kind of special thing that we do to keep ourselves safe. Now these things, it needs your own attention.
Mm-hmm.
You make it yourself. If you feel that you need to change it, change it. If you don't feel, if you don't think that you need to change it, don't change it. So, but I change it maybe in a month or so. I don't change it before.
So we burn it?
No, why burn it?
Then what do we do with that, the one which we are replacing at that point
you
of time?
You can throw it away because it's absorbed the negativity.
Can bury
since
it?
You can flush it.
All the negativities
can be flushed away from your life. You don't need to bury it. You don't need to burn it. Nothing is required.
Okay.
All you need to do is just flush it. Or you can just put it in the garbage. Because we don't want negativity in our life. We throw it in the garbage.
So I'll come back again with this, a lot of people have questions regarding what are the, why one should bury, one should, burn, why one should, throw it in the water, why one should, put it in the dustbin. So we'll make another video where I will come up with these questions, where people get a little bit of more clarity what to do when they're doing a certain kind of a ritual. Thank you for sharing. Thank you.
Thank you.